Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Masks of Vienna. Chapter 1. The Antique Collector's Discovery. In the heart of Vienna, where the past lingers in the music-filled air and the ornate architecture, Stefan, an esteemed antique collector, ran a quaint shop tucked away in a cobblestone alley. His shop was a treasure trove of history, filled with artifacts and relics that whispered stories of bygone eras. Stefan, a man in his late 40s with a keen eye for rare finds and an even keener sense of history, was respected in collector circles for his uncanny ability to unearth unusual antiques. Stefan got package from a recently dead aristocrat's estate sale one chilly autumn morning. The collection included antique jewels, worn-out paintings, dusty books, and elaborate furniture. But one object in particular, an old mask, drew Stefan's attention. There was nothing like this mask that he had ever seen. It was exquisitely made, with elaborate patterns engraved into the surface and sparkling jewels that gave off an ethereal glow in the store's low light. The mask had an air of mystery about it. Its design was not characteristic of any particular era or culture that Stefan could immediately recognize. Intrigued, he decided to research the mask's origin. He spent hours poring over old books and documents, consulting his extensive network of historians and fellow collectors, but the mask remained an enigma. Its origins, its maker, and its history were a blank page in the annals of time. As Stefan delved deeper into his research, he began to experience strange occurrences. When handling the mask, he felt a subtle yet unmistakable surge of energy, a sensation that left him both exhilarated and uneasy. He noticed that his dreams became vivid on nights when the mask was nearby, filled with images of grand balls and opulent gatherings from a bygone era. Determined to uncover the mask's secrets, Stefan visited the city archives, delving into the history of the aristocrat from whom the mask had come. The archives revealed that the mask had been in the aristocrat's family for generations, but its origins were shrouded in secrecy. It was said to have been a prized possession of a countess known for her beauty and influence in Vienna's high society during the late 18th century. Legends spoke of the mask being a gift from a mysterious admirer, who claimed that it would grant the wearer a power unlike any other, a power of allure and persuasion. The more Stefan learned about the mask, the more he became convinced of its unusual nature. He started to wear the mask in the solitude of his shop, curious about its alleged powers. To his astonishment, he began to feel different when wearing it, more confident, more charismatic. His interactions with customers and acquaintances took on a new dynamic, as if he was more attuned to their thoughts and emotions. Word of Stefan's remarkable mask spread, piquing the interest of collectors and historians alike. People began to visit his shop not just for the antiques, but to catch a glimpse of the mysterious mask. Stefan was cautious, aware that the mask, if truly possessed of the powers it was rumored to have, was a valuable and potentially dangerous artifact. One evening, as the winter fog enveloped the city, Stefan was visited by a woman who introduced herself as a historian specializing in European aristocracy. She was particularly interested in the mask and its history. As they discussed the artifact, Stefan felt a sense of unease, as if the mask was somehow influencing their conversation. The historian was enigmatic, her interest in the mask more than academic curiosity. After she left, Stefan stood in his shop, the mask in his hands, pondering the web of history and mystery in which he had become entangled. He realized that the mask was more than a mere artifact. It was a key to a forgotten chapter of Vienna's past, a chapter filled with intrigue and hidden power. Driven by a desire to understand the mask's true nature and origins, Stefan decided to delve deeper into Vienna's aristocratic history. He planned to visit the city's grand palaces and estates, hoping to uncover clues about the mask's past owner, the Countess, and the mysterious admirer who had gifted it. As he locked up his shop for the night, Stefan felt a mix of excitement and apprehension. He was about to embark on a journey through Vienna's opulent and shadowy history, following a trail set by a mask that had captivated and mystified him. The streets of Vienna, with their silent statues and whispering winds, seemed to beckon him into a world of long-lost secrets and hidden agendas. The mystery of the mask, with its unknown powers and obscured past, was a puzzle that Stefan was determined to solve. Little did he know that his quest would take him beyond the realms of history and into the very heart of the city's aristocratic circles, where power and seduction played a dangerous game. Chapter 2. The Mask's Secret. Stefan's quest to unearth the origins of the enigmatic mask led him through Vienna's grand history, a journey that wove through the city's opulent palaces, dusty archives, and elegant salons. His days were spent in rigorous research, tracing the lineage of the aristocratic family from whom he had acquired the mask. The evenings found him in his shop, poring over ancient manuscripts and documents, often with the mask resting ominously on his desk. As he delved deeper into the history, Stefan discovered that the mask was linked to Countess Elizabeth Fonor, a figure shrouded in both allure and mystery. Living during the late 1700s, the Countess was known for her striking beauty and her influential role in Vienna's high society. Her life was a tapestry of lavish parties, political intrigue, and romantic escapades. The mask, according to Stefan's findings, was said to have been a gift from a secret admirer, a figure who remained unnamed in the annals of history. This admirer claimed that the mask would bestow upon the Countess a power like no other, an irresistible charm and influence over those she encountered. Intrigued by these revelations, Stefan decided to experiment with the mask at social gatherings. He attended various events in the city, from art exhibitions to antique auctions, wearing the mask under the guise of a historical costume. To his astonishment, he found that people were inexplicably drawn to him, hanging on his every word and vying for his attention. It wasn't just the allure of a masked figure at these gatherings, it was as if the mask had an aura that affected those around him. conversations revealed secrets, desires, and intentions that people would not normally disclose, making Stefan a confidant to many. He realized that the mask indeed possessed a mysterious power, one that opened doors and unveiled the hidden machinations of Vienna's elite. One night, at a masquerade ball in a grand Viennese palace, Stefan's use of the mask took an unexpected turn. Amidst the swirl of gowns and the melody of waltzes, he encountered a woman who seemed immune to the mask's charm. She introduced herself as Helena, a historian with a deep interest in the city's esoteric past. Helena was well-versed in the legends surrounding the Countess and her mysterious admirer. She shared with Stefan her research, which suggested that the admirer was a member of an obscure alchemical society that sought to influence the city's aristocratic circles. The mask, according to her theory, was a tool, a means to sway the social and political tides of Vienna. Their conversation was a revelation to Stefan. He began to see the mask not just as an artifact of personal allure, but as a piece in a larger puzzle, a relic of a time when mysticism and power went hand in hand. Helena's insights prompted Stefan to investigate the alchemical societies of Vienna, delving into a world where science, mysticism, and power intersected. His research led him to the National Library, where hidden within ancient texts and forgotten manuscripts, he uncovered references to a secret society known as the Order of the Luminous. The Order, shrouded in mystery, was said to have dabbled in alchemy, astrology, and other esoteric practices, seeking knowledge that would give them control over both the material and spiritual realms. The more Stefan learned about the Order, the more he realized the significance of the mask. It was not just a symbol of seduction, it was an instrument of influence, designed by the Order to advance their agenda within Vienna's power circles. This realization put Stefan in a precarious position. The mask, with its intricate ties to the city's past, was a key to understanding a hidden chapter of Vienna's history. Yet, its powers were not to be taken lightly. The influence it wielded could be a tool for manipulation, just as it had been in the hands of the Countess centuries ago. Stefan's investigation also attracted unwanted attention. His frequent visits to the library and his growing reputation as a collector of rare artifacts made him a person of interest to those who were aware of the mask's true nature. He noticed figures lurking in the shadows, following his movements, a sign that the descendants of the Order were still active, guarding their secrets. Amidst this web of history and intrigue, Stefan found himself at a crossroads. The mask, a link to a forgotten era of alchemy and aristocracy, held a power that was both alluring and dangerous. As he stood in his shop one evening, the mask in his hands, he pondered his next move. Should he continue to delve into the mask's past, uncovering the secrets of the Order and the role they played in shaping Vienna's history? Or should he heed the cautionary tales of the past and keep the mask's powers a closely guarded secret? The streets of Vienna, with their Baroque beauty and echoes of a bygone era, seemed to hold their breath as Stefan weighed his decision. The mystery of the mask, a relic of an age where power and mysticism intertwined, was a puzzle that Stefan was determined to solve, yet wary of the shadows it cast. Chapter 3. A Dance of Intrigue. The more Stefan wore the mask at social events, the more he felt ensnared in a web of intrigue that sprawled across Vienna's aristocratic circles. The mask's influence was subtle yet profound, drawing out the hidden desires and secrets of those he interacted with. It was a dance of power and seduction, with Stefan unwittingly becoming the center of attention at every gathering he attended. As Stefan navigated these high society events, he became acutely aware of the shifting dynamics around him. The mask seemed to not only reveal the intentions of others, but also to enhance his own intuition and understanding. He found himself privy to confidential conversations, whispered rumors, and clandestine affairs, all which painted a picture of a society rife with political maneuvering and personal ambitions. However, Stefan's growing influence did not go unnoticed. He began to attract the attention of certain influential individuals, including a mysterious baroness known for her keen interest in art and antiquities. The baroness, a woman of striking beauty and intelligence, approached Stefan with a proposition. She was aware of the mask's history and believed that Stefan was the key to unlocking its full potential. She offered him access to her extensive resources and connections in exchange for his collaboration in exploring the mask's powers. Torn between curiosity and caution, Stefan agreed to a discreet partnership with the Baroness. Their alliance opened doors to private salons, exclusive gatherings, and the inner workings of Vienna's elite. The Baroness proved to be a valuable ally, providing Stefan with insights into the history of the city's aristocracy and the secret societies that had long operated within its shadows. As their partnership deepened, Stefan found himself drawn into a game of political intrigue. He learned of a power struggle brewing within the city, one that hinged on the acquisition and control of certain artifacts and relics, the mask among them. It became clear that the mask was not merely a remnant of the past, but a key piece in a contemporary battle for influence and control. The more Stefan delved into this hidden world, the more he realized the danger he was in. The mask's powers were coveted by many, and he had inadvertently become a pawn in a much larger game. His every move was being watched, not just by the Baroness and her circle, but by other, more shadowy figures who sought to claim the mask for their own purposes. Amidst this dangerous game, Stefan's relationship with Helena, the historian he had met earlier, grew stronger. Helena provided a grounding presence, reminding Stefan of the importance of preserving history and protecting its artifacts from misuse. Together, they began to piece together the history of the mask and its connection to the secret societies of Vienna. Their investigation turned up an old document stashed away in the National Library's archives. Written by one of the Order of the Luminous, the document described the mask's construction and intended use. It became clear that the mask was a key to reaching higher states of awareness and comprehension, as well as a tool for influence and seduction. Stefan was forced to consider the moral ramifications of his conduct as he struggled with these insights. Though unknowingly, he had been manipulating others around him while navigating the world of the aristocracy with the mask on. Although the mask's power was alluring, there was a moral price to be paid. The climax of Stefan's journey through the aristocratic circles of Vienna came at a grand masquerade ball hosted by the Baroness. The ball, a spectacle of opulence and elegance, was also a convergence point for the various factions vying for power within the city. Stefan, wearing the mask, found himself at the heart of a complex web of alliances and enmities. At the ball, Amidst the swirl of masked figures and the strains of a waltz, Stefan was confronted by a mysterious figure who claimed to be a descendant of the Order of the Luminous. This figure revealed the true purpose of the mask. It was meant to be a guide for those seeking to transcend the mundane and access the deeper mysteries of the universe. Faced with this revelation, Stefan was forced to make a choice. He could continue to use the mask for personal gain, aligning himself with the Baroness and her quest for power, or he could heed the words of the mysterious descendant and use the mask to explore the higher truths it was meant to reveal. The decision weighed heavily on Stefan. The allure of power and influence was tempting, but the possibility of uncovering the true nature of the mask and its ancient knowledge was a call to a higher purpose. As the ball reached its crescendo, Stefan made his decision. He chose to break away from the Baroness's influence and dedicate himself to understanding the mask's true purpose. With Helena's support, he resolved to protect the mask from those who would misuse it and to explore the deeper mysteries it held. The night of the ball marked a turning point for Stefan. He had entered Vienna's aristocratic society as a curious antique collector, but he emerged as a guardian of a powerful and ancient legacy. The mask, once a symbol of seduction and intrigue, became a beacon on his journey to uncover the hidden truths of the past and the potential of the human spirit. Chapter 4. The Masquerade Unveiled. The Grand Masquerade Ball, hosted in one of Vienna's most opulent palaces, was a spectacle of extravagance and intrigue. Beneath the shimmering chandeliers and amongst the rustling of silk gowns, the city's elite moved with a grace and poise that belied the undercurrents of power and ambition. Stefan, adorned with the ancient mask, moved among them, the weight of his recent discoveries pressing heavily on his mind. As the evening progressed, the mask's influence was undeniable. Stefan found himself at the center of attention, a magnet for admirers and schemers alike. The Baroness, resplendent in her own ornate mask, watched him with a knowing eye, her earlier proposition hanging between them like a silent promise. However, it was the appearance of a mysterious figure that marked the turning point of the evening. This enigmatic individual, cloaked and masked, approached Stefan with a quiet urgency. They revealed themselves as a direct descendant of the Order of the Luminous, the secret society that had originally created the masked in a secluded alcove, away from the prying eyes and ears of the party. The descendant unveiled the true history of the mask. It was created not as a mere tool for social manipulation, but as a conduit for higher understanding. The Order of the Luminous, steeped in alchemical and mystical practices, had sought to explore realms beyond the ordinary perception, and the mask was a key to unlocking these realms. The revelation shook Stefan to his core. The mask's powers, which he had witnessed and even exploited, were just the surface of its true potential. The descendant implored Stefan to use the mask responsibly, warning that its misuse could lead to consequences far beyond the social and political games of Vienna's elite. Stefan, faced with this revelation, felt a deep conflict within himself. The allure of the power he had tasted was intoxicating, yet the wisdom imparted by the descendant resonated with his own sense of morality. He realized that the mask was not a plaything of the aristocracy, but a relic of profound significance. As the ball reached its zenith, the Baroness approached Stefan with a proposal to use the mask to shift the balance of power in Vienna. She spoke of alliances and couplings, of political maneuverings that the mask could influence to their advantage. Her vision was a Vienna reshaped by their hands, with the mask as their instrument. Stefan, however, saw a different path. Inspired by the descendant's words and Helena's counsel, he declined the Baroness's offer. He resolved to protect the mask from those who would use it for personal gain, including himself. His decision was met with a cold fury from the Baroness, who warned him of the consequences of his choice. The masquerade ball, with its facade of gaiety, had become the stage for a more profound drama. Stefan removed the mask and, in doing so, symbolically rejected the seductive lure of power and control it offered. The room, abuzz with music and laughter, seemed to fade into the background as Stefan made his decision. He knew that this choice would alter his path forever, distancing him from the aristocratic world he had become a part of and marking him as a guardian of a secret too potent to be wielded lightly. With the support of Helena and the guidance of the descendant of the Order of the Luminous, Stefan embarked on a new journey. He dedicated himself to studying the mask's deeper mysteries and the ancient knowledge of the Order. His antique shop became a front for this more secretive and profound pursuit, a haven for his research and exploration into the realms of the mystical and esoteric. Stefan's days were spent in study and contemplation, deciphering the writings of the Order, experimenting with the mask's properties, and understanding its connection to higher realms of consciousness. The mask, once a symbol of external influence and power, became an instrument of internal exploration and enlightenment. However, Stefan's decision to keep the mask's true nature hidden and to delve into its secrets did not go unnoticed. The Baroness and her circle, feeling spurned and threatened by his refusal, became silent adversaries. Stefan had to navigate not only the complexities of his newfound path, but also the dangers posed by those who sought to claim the mask for their own purposes. Despite these challenges, Stefan found fulfillment in his new role. He forged a deep connection with the descendant of the Order, who became a mentor and guide in his exploration of the mystical. Helena, ever his steadfast partner, supported his endeavors, helping to bridge the gap between the ancient knowledge and the modern world. The masquerade ball became a distant memory, a turning point in Stefan's life where he chose a path less traveled. He realized that the true power of the mask lay not in its ability to influence others, but in its capacity to reveal the deeper aspects of the self and the universe. Years passed, and Stefan became a guardian of a bygone era's wisdom, a keeper of secrets that held the potential to enlighten and transform. The mask, a relic of a time when science, mysticism, and power were intertwined, became a symbol of his journey from a collector of antiquities to a seeker of truths hidden within and beyond. The streets of Vienna, with their timeless elegance and echoes of a rich and complex history, continued to hold their secrets. Stefan, once a mere spectator of the city's past, had become an integral part of its hidden narrative, a custodian of a legacy that bridged the mystical and the mundane. In his shop, among the relics of the past, Stefan pondered the journey that had brought him here. The mask, now resting in a place of honor, was no longer just an artifact of intrigue, it was a testament to his journey into the depths of history and the human psyche.
Thank you.